Hey, it's Greta from AppRater. Today we're going to focus on analyzing your ratings and reviews and how to best report on your user feedback. Ratings and reviews are the publicly available feedback your users are providing as social proof on your app, inside the app stores. According to statistics, 79% of users check ratings and reviews before downloading a new app and only consider apps with at least 3-star rating. People simply tend to trust the opinions of others. So it becomes self-evident that positive user feedback is crucial for influencing App Store visitors to buy your app. And monitoring and replying to your existing reviews is what helps you get there. So how to reply to hundreds of reviews in different languages and catch the highlights of them in reporting? We've got 5 steps to go through to have your reviews replied and reporting done. Keep in mind, there is an integration with App Stores needed for this workflow. So make sure to connect your AppRater account with your Apple and Google developer account beforehand. Step 1. Check out your user feedback based on star ratings in each relevant country. Are your users saying the same in Germany and Sweden, or does their opinion vary in different countries? Is it improving or getting worse on a monthly basis? Also, your app rating should reflect the improvements you're regularly making to your app. Step 2. Read and categorize the feedback. Go to the review section that lists all of your Google and Apple user reviews. You can filter based on time frame, country, ratings, and whether you've already replied to the review or not. Step 3. Reply to your reviews. Simply write your personal answer to the user and press reply. By promptly responding to all the reviews your app receives, you'll be showing both your current and potential future users that you care about their experience with your product. Also, users tend to change their initially negative rating into a positive one once they've received a reply. Step 4. Translate reviews that are not in your native language. It's pretty usual that apps available worldwide get user reviews in many different languages. This is global feedback about your product on your fingertips, so take use of it. In your AppRater account, you can easily translate the reviews to English, and you can also translate your replies so the user receives reply in his/her local language. Step 5. Set up a daily review alert. This means AppRater will send you a notification via email or Slack about your new reviews so you can reply fast. Step 6. Create a monthly report on your user feedback. Go to Review Summaries feature and let AI summarize the most important feature suggestions and customer feedback for the selected country and time period. Share with your product team what your users want to be improved and make these priority fixes for your next app update. Once you've released the new features and bug fixes, go back to your app reviews and let your users know that you've solved the problems they were facing and see how your reviews are improving. And now 3 pro tips. Pro tip 1, the best way to get more ratings is just to ask your users. Pro tip 2, in case you mess up an answer to a user, you can still edit the already published answers in AppRater. All you have to do is click on Edit Reply and submit the new response. Pro tip 3, create templates or use the pre-made ones from AppRater. This makes the entire process much faster and improves your overall customer service. To summarize, to effectively manage your user feedback in app stores, make sure to read and reply to your reviews from different countries. Translate your user feedback and reply to it in the local language by using pre-made templates to provide fast customer service. Set up review alerts to never miss any user feedback and use AI to easily provide insights from the market to your product team. If at any time you need help with the above, schedule an onboarding session with one of our awesome customer success managers or consider our agency services. We're here to help you succeed. And now, let's get to work.